Hello children, our today's topic is acid, its type, dilution of acid and its properties. Acids are those chemical substances which produce hydrogen ions in aqueous solution. For example, if you are taking any acid and you are dissolving in water, you will get hydrogen ion which are responsible for the acidic properties in acid solution. You must have tasted fruits like lemon, orange, which are sour in taste. The sour taste is due to the presence of organic acid into them. The certain acids which are produced from minerals are called mineral acids. There are three common mineral acids, which are hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid and nitric acid. Now, types of acids. There are two types of acid, strong acids and weak acids. Strong acids are those which used to ionize completely on dissolving in water. For example, if you are taking 100 molecule of hydrochloric acid and you dissolved in water, all 100 molecule of HCl will give you 100 hydrogen ions and 100 Cl ions. All mineral acids are strong acids. Weak acids are those which used to give partial hydrogen ions. That means if you are taking 100 acetic acid molecules and you are dissolving in water, out of 100 acetic acid molecules, you will get 20-25 ions of hydrogen. Now, next term is concentrated and dilute acids. Concentrated acids are those acids in which there is a minimum possible amount of water is present. Whereas dilute acids, which are made by mixing of concentrated acid into water. Now the next topic is how to convert concentrated acid into dilute acids or diluting acids or dilution. The process of mixing of water in concentrated acid is highly exothermic. The dilution of concentrated acid should always be done by adding concentrated acid in water, not by adding water in concentrated. Please hear it again. We used to dilute acid by adding acid in water, not water in acid. Why? Because when concentrated acid is added in water, heat is evolved gradually and easily absorbed by large amount of water. And this process used to be done by adding concentrated acid by the walls of the beaker and with constant stirring. If water is added in concentrated acid, large amount of heat used to be evolved at once. And this heat changes some of the water into steam explosively, which can splash the acid on the face of the user or on the clothes and can cause acid burns. That is why we always add concentrated acid in water to dilute it. Next topic is the properties of acids. First property, you already know, acids are sour in taste. Acids turns red, blue litmus red. Next, acid used to conduct electricity because of the presence of free ions. Next, acid used to react with metals to form hydrogen gas. That means when you are taking any acid and you are adding metal into it, for example, zinc metal, you will get metal salt and hydrogen gas. See the equation. When I am adding zinc granules in hydrochloric acid, and hydrochloric acid, here I am taking dilute. So hydrogen gas is liberating. By this reaction, we can also show that acids are the compounds which contain hydrogen. How can we prove now in this reaction, hydrogen gas is liberated? We can prove, for example, if you are taking this acid in test tube and you added zinc granules into it, hydrogen gas will start liberating in a form of bubbles. Hydrogen gas is colorless and odorless gas. When it starts liberating from the test tube and you bring a burning matchstick over the mouth of test tube, you will see it will burn with pop sound. Pop sound indicates the little explosion because hydrogen is highly, highly inflammable gas. It is considered as one of the excellent fuel. Next property is when acid reacts with metal carbonates or hydrogen carbonates, for example, sodium carbonate or sodium bicarbonate. One gas used to liberate, which is called carbon dioxide, along with metal salt and water will form. Now, if you take sodium carbonate or sodium bicarbonate and you added hydrochloric acid into them, what will happen? Sodium chloride will form along with the formation of carbon dioxide. Now again, we want to prove the liberated gas is carbon dioxide. We will take this carbon dioxide collected in one of the test tube and pass this gas into lime water solution, that means calcium hydroxide solution. On passing this gas in calcium hydroxide solution, lime water becomes milky due to the formation of calcium carbonate. And when this calcium carbonate containing solution we are taking and keep on passing carbon dioxide gas into it, the solution becomes colorless now due to the formation of calcium bicarbonate. So, this is the confirmatory test of carbon dioxide gas. Next reaction is neutralization reaction. When any acid is added to base, they will form salt and water. In this reaction, what is happening? Actually, acid is killing the basic nature of base, and base is killing the acidic nature of acid. So actually acid and base are neutralizing each other. That is why this reaction is called neutralization reaction. In this neutralization reaction, for example, if we take example NaOH and HCl, here NaOH is base and HCl is acid. So what will happen? OH ion will come from sodium hydroxide, H ion will come from HCl, and by the combination of these two, that means H ion will combine with OH ion to give you water molecule. This is the mechanism of this neutralization reaction. Next, same reaction, when acid is reacting with metal oxide, what will happen? Salt will form along with the water molecule. And when non-metallic oxide react with base, so non-metallic oxide here is carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is reacting with base, calcium hydroxide. Calcium carbonate will form. And the last property, acids are highly corrosive in nature. They can never be stored in metal containers. They should always be stored in glass or ceramic containers, because glass and ceramic containers generally not attacked by acids. Children, go through these slides and I will send you notes tomorrow. Thank you.